Approximately almost 5 foot long, thick, full of muscle, this was the beautiful monster snake that I was hoping to find.
So this is your favorite snake species, eh?
This one and the leather snake. Yeah. I love leather snakes. But this one, you can see how intelligent they are.
Yeah.
They're like very visual snakes. They always are looking at you. This one is trying to bite me right now, but it's really cold, so it's not going to achieve it.
How many of these guys do you reckon you've caught in your lifetime?
In my lifetime?
Yeah.
I don't know. That's a difficult question. I think maybe, 100, 150, 200.
Yeah.
As big as this one, not so many.
Yeah.
Maybe 30 or so. But Montpellier snakes in general, like a lot of them. It's the most common snake around here, so.
Yeah. Man, such a beautiful animal.
Absolutely stunning. I want a formal introduction to this animal.
Alright man, what have we got here?
So here we have a Montpellier snake, Malpolon mons pesulanus in Latin. And yeah, it's a big male. You can see it is a big male because it has like really uniform pattern.
Yeah.
A big black dot like there on the neck, like there.
Yeah.
And it has like a greenish neck head. And yeah, the males are the only ones that get so big. Females normally tend to stay a little bit smaller, like 1.2 meters, 1.3.
Beautiful, man.
And they don't get this thick because this is a thick snake, well fed snake. And yes, that's it. This is the most common snake around here with leather snake.
Mm.
So this is the snake I've always seen during my whole lifetime. So yeah, it's a great snake.
That's amazing,
and it's the queen of the snakes here in this area and in whole Spain.
Yeah.
Because it eats all snake, it eats vipers.
Mm-hmm.
It can now with the climate change, these ones are going like upper north because of the warmer weather.
Yeah.
And they are moving like vipers more north because they eat them. For these ones it's better. Like they have more areas where they can thrive because the warmer weather. But for vipers, for example, that usually live in colder weathers and they have no predators like Malpolomus pesulanus, it's an issue because there are snakes like this one or the horseshoe whip snake, Emorrhoides hippocrepis, that are going upper north because of the warmer temperatures.
Yeah.
So it's a problem for them, but it's good for these ones.
Yeah. So in this area, we're kind of in like farmland right now. sorry, that was amazing. This guy, what's his main source of prey around here?
Like around here, I think the main sources of prey are rodents, rabbits, small rabbits, and a big guy like this one, a 1.6 meter one, can take down a decently big rabbit, not a full grown one, but like a medium sized rabbit, he can take it no problem.
Yeah, decent size.
And he also preys on other snakes, like very frequently, like leather snakes, also other Montpellier snakes when they are out of the breeding season.
Yeah.
And yeah, they are just amazing. They are the ultimate hunter, like around here.
That's amazing.
Yeah, this is the biggest snake in Europe, like the species that.